Hi, this is Sylvia with the Tejano Nation, and we are here with
Jaime DeAnda y
Los Furiosos.
And we are at the Tejano Explosion for Fiesta 2022. They just got done with their first set, and we wanted to meet the band and, of course, talk to Jaime. As everyone knows, he went through a life-altering experience in December, but he bounced back incredibly less than 2 months later to be back on the stage and performing, and he's going strong and not showing any signs of slowing down. So do you just want to start off by just saying, how are you doing? I'm sure you're getting tired of that question, but how are you feeling? How are you doing?
Well, you know, not really. I appreciate everyone asking and concern. That's the first thing of all. My fans out there, my family, everybody, all my friends out there that's been supportive and stuff to let you know that, well, we all go through some kind of a change, and we never know what's, health-wise, we never know what's the outcome. But the good thing is, everybody's support really picks you up. It's like better than medication, you know, the prayers out there, you know, hearing it so much that, you know, hey, get back up, come on, get on stage, get, you know, you got to do what you got to do, and you know, you have, and then my team behind me that's ready, I mean, ready for whatever's going to happen, and that's what's the hardest thing to do is say, you know what, I can do it again. I'm ready. I can. It's just, you know, taking that time of, you know, a lot of people thinking, oh, well, is he going to be able to, or how long is it going to be? Hey, our bodies are all different. We never know. But all I know is Julian made me eat a lot of protein, kinds of milk, all kinds of stuff, because, and they were giving me all kinds of vitamins and everything. But, you know, I feel really good. I feel much better.
That's good, because you didn't just go through anything minor. We could have lost you, and that is changes, I'm sure, everything about how you think about life, to how you feel, to what you have to do now. Just really quickly, tell people what happened. When did you know something was wrong?
I guess when I wasn't breathing. No, almost.
That would be a sign, though.
A big sign.
Yeah, yeah.
Well, you know, it started from a toothache, and I just thought it was, I thought it was just a toothache, and I thought I had cracked my wisdom tooth in the back, and well, I didn't think I had any, but well, no, something was going on back there. But from there, it started turning into an infection, I believe, and I was taking antibiotics slowly, hoping it was going to help. But before you know it, instead of helping, it was like, it felt like it helped me, but then it felt like, no, it's not, because now I'm having a hard time swallowing. I feel like my tongue was getting like thicker, and I said, man, I can't chew much, and I feel that I'm really not eating, you know, I'm eating less and less, and I kept saying, it'll go away. You know how we are. We don't want to go to the doctor. It's the last thing we always say, because if you go to the doctor, what do they say when you go to the hospital? You don't come back. Everybody says that. It's not like a movie, you know, and that's what I thought, you know, and my mom and everybody started, I couldn't talk anymore for a while. I wasn't talking to nobody. I just felt that something doesn't seem right. You know, because I've gone through secondhand smoke operation in 2004.
Oh, okay. I didn't know that.
So, you know, that's one sign that's not good already, knowing that, you know, you have a weak lung. And they finally took me in, and they said, bring him in. One doctor says, look, you need to see an oral doctor. I said, that's not my department. But then another doctor came in, and he says, look, right now, this man, we need to put a fakeo down his throat right now. He's not breathing. Can you see that? Can you see that? And he told my wife, look, you have 1 minute to decide. If you don't, this guy has a 50-50 chance of living right now.
Wow.
And I'm hearing all this, and I'm thinking, so what? He didn't even wait for her to answer. They just took off, and they grabbed me, and they took me to the other side. For a moment, I thought, I didn't even get to say goodbye. They just took running in the other room.
So like the reality of it started hitting you.
Yeah, more and more. And they're getting all these needles ready and everything. And I'm like, before you know it, he goes, don't worry, we got you. He put that mask on me little by little.
And everything went away, huh?
I don't remember nothing. All I remember that the next day I woke up, I was in another hospital because they said they had to do some incisions around my neck. That they had to take out the infection. So my esophagus would open up more and more because it was, I don't know, for some reason, it was so swollen that it was closing my windpipe. Doc, be honest, is my voice going to change? I was worried. I said, what's next? He said, well, it's...
That's your livelihood. That's how you make your living.
I said, why am I starting like this? I don't know what's going to happen. I don't know. You know, so yeah. I'm thinking, well, the good part is hearing my wife tell me how many people were praying and looking out for you, and everybody, that all the fans out there that were scared and worried, and family and everybody, you know. And then you do, you start thinking about, wow, I actually went through something that, man, for the first time I heard that, hey, I could make it or could not make it. It is, you know, it is scary when it happens to you. It's when you really feel that second chance now and say, wow, we need to take care of ourselves. We need to try to do better for ourselves if we can, because we're so used to not. I mean, we take our body, we work it to death, you know. We work all night, our weekends, the jobs that we have. We don't eat right sometimes. We're always on the road.
The touring and all of that, like, took its toll.
And the studio and practicing, rehearsal and stuff. And you know, working together as a team, it's a lot of work. I've been in the business for so long. And to know that I still have a team that's right here supportive and behind me, that's saying, hey, we got you. That's a big plus.
That's awesome. That's nice to know. Before we get to meeting your team, it's just amazing to everyone, too, that less than 2 months after you were released from the hospital, you were already back up and performing. How did you do that?
I don't know, but Julie kept telling me, and you better not go up there and start dancing so much and doing all this stuff. And it's crazy because, you know, we have our fans out there that are crazy and they're looking at me, because I knew the doctor says, look, take it easy. You know, I know, now that I told him what I do and perform and dancing and stuff like this. Well, you know, just take it easy. You know what your body can take, and you don't want to overdo it, and I'll see you again here or whatever could happen. But the thing is getting the courage to go back up on stage, to grab the instrument, to feel and to know, are we going to be able to sing? How is it going to sound? What's going to happen? How many haters are going to be out there saying this and that? Well, that's always there, you know?
It's always a part of it.
Yeah, it's a part of it. And it's funny because, you know, when I was out there, one guy's saying, come on, I'm a dance. Come on, dance. And I did a couple of jumps, and Judas on the side saying, watch it. Slow down. But, you know, it's just the energy. You know, the energy and the people, how they are. And it felt good to see that. Again, I lost like 40 something pounds.
Yeah, I was gonna say you look slimmer. Yeah. But that could be a good thing too, though.
You know,
he lost it, I found it.
You found his lost weight.
Getting health wise, getting back on track and doing what we gotta do, going back in the studio, giving the people the music what we gotta do. I'm doing my best.
That's awesome. And what do you want to say to fans who are worried about you, or like you even mentioned the haters who are saying, oh, he looks tired, oh, he's not himself, or he's not going to get back up to where he was? What do you want to say to those people?
I want to say thank you, because even though everyone out there has their own opinion, which will never stop, everybody has to have a, you know, think what they want to think and say what and express what they feel, I appreciate the fact that they still made time to think about me. I appreciate that, and they prayed, and supportive, and coming to the shows. And believe me, it might be tough for all of us to feel that anytime we come out of any kind of surgery, they don't come out 100% at the moment. But you know what? It's having the strength to say, you know what? I will do it again. I can do it again, and I'll be on stage, and I'm going to give it all I can. And thank you guys, and be ready for some new music coming out.
Awesome. We can't wait for that. Do you want to introduce us to this team behind you that you're so proud of?
Oh, God, I am very proud. These guys are, they're heck of a musicians. They've grown up since they were kids listening to my music. I can't believe it. And now they show it on stage. They show it in the studio. They show it when we're practicing. It's the energy they give me now. They're making me feel back like it wasn't back in the days. Everybody says, yeah, man, where did the 80s and 90s go? You know what? They're always there. It's just what you do. However you do. But these guys, for one, my bajo player, I'll let him say his name.
Okay, let's meet. Who are you and what do you do? I mean, what do you play? You know what I mean.
My name is Stevie Ray Vavages, and I play bajo sexto.
And what is your background?
I'm full-blooded Native American from Arizona, and I grew up listening to Jaime. So, and I've also, previous, I was with Bobby Pulido for 4 years, and Los Tex Maniacs, and Flavio Longoria, Boni Mauricio, and so I got the offer from Jaime and the guys, and couldn't resist.
So you definitely have a lot of experience behind you with some major names. Oh, yeah. You're not new to this.
Jaime was one of my first influences, so a lot of the things I did with other groups, it was because of Jaime's original group.
That's awesome.
That's kind of one of my many foundations.
Awesome. And you, and what do you do?
I'm Aaron Holler. Okay. My name's Aaron Holler. I'm the drummer from Jaime DeAnda Los Furiosos. You may recognize me from my stint with Jay Pettis. I was here for quite some time. Then went to Bobby Pulido, then went to Gary, then went to Ram, then went to Joe Lopez.
So you just started. You're pretty new.
I've been here about a year now. Like, all kidding aside, I've been here for a year now. So we're here in the studio right now. We obviously put a single out with Evan Quintanilla. We did that at my studio, Art of Holler Music. So, you know, I try to be a jack of all trades, master of none.
And what made you want to join Jaime DeAnda?
I got a call from Julian, who likes to remain in the background, and she turned the camera to him since he loves it.
Well, we'll get some footage of Julian later.
So I had announced my departure from Joe Lopez, and he had messaged me, said, "Hey, I've got some dates for you. Are you available?" I was like, "Are you even hiding around a rock or what?" I said, "Not only am I available, I'm permanently available." He says, "Well, you know, let's come try it out and let's see how it goes." Well, I'm still here.
That's awesome. Great. And then your name and what do you do?
I'm Pete Gutierrez. They call me Tiny. I play bass and do some backup vocals. Started back in the day. We had a high school band called Los Chavalos. Then I started playing with Eddie Gonzalez. And then with Elida. And then little stint with Fama. Then with Sunny. That's like about 15 years. Sunny's outside about 15 years there. And then recently I was playing with J.R. Gomez, Segundo Bandits. And now here with Jaime.
And how did you wind up here with Jaime?
Timing, you know, God's timing, I guess. You know, it was supposed to happen a lot sooner, you know. It wasn't time, but now it was the right time to do it, you know. And it feels really good, you know, feeling this was really good to be jamming with actually a buddy of mine that I've been wanting to jam for years, and these guys, you know, for a long time, always kind of in passing here and there, and actually be in a band with these guys now, it and then of course with Jaime, you know, it's just, I mean, it's timing, you know, so it's a cool thing.
What can you say?
Yeah, and just trying to see what we could do and get this music back to where the old good times, where it was, and just kick some butt on stage and put on good shows for the fans out there. So
you're back. You're not going anywhere. So only more to come, right?
I'm hoping to stay here. Yes, man, and bring a lot more, of course, to the show. And thank everyone, you know, for, you know, coming out to supporting our show, especially tonight. Everyone that came out here from out of state, from all over. It's been fun. It's just the beginning right now. That's all I can say.
Great.
Be surprised for what's coming out.
Awesome. Well, just, do you want to say anything to your fans and or to TejanoNation.net, the readers?
Thank all of you guys for, you know, keeping all our history, all the years of support and going to the shows. Don't forget buying CDs and, you know, especially going to the shows. Support the band. Support, you know, our shows and stuff. It's important because it's what makes us continue to bring music. And like I said on stage once, well, earlier, you know, music, who doesn't? No matter what it is or what style, everyone loves music for sure. And that's what it's all about. And if we can bring it to you and make you happy, come out and keep showing your support, and you know, that's what counts. Really, it's what counts for us to continue doing what we love to do.
Great. Well, I thank you for your time, and thank all of you for y'all's time, and glad to have you back, and glad that you stayed with us. So it was an honor. Thank you so much.
Yes, ma'am.